if you talking that dumb shit, cause you the type to go and make all these assumptions. Practice what I preach it, I'm proud to. I'ma do this all, baby, with or without you. I'm ready, ready. I'm ready, oh. I'm ready, ready. I'm ready, oh. My mama still screaming, ain't no convincing me. It ain't over, we still living like Vincent E. Just envision.
It's just to give away free art throughout the city. I'm doing it for 10 days. It's just to brighten people's days.
Peggy Sue in the pens with Pino and good friends. I know it's gonna take me to lose over and over again. To fall on my face.
It's not a scam. Would you like free art? No? Okay. Kids tend to be the easiest people they want to run right over. And a lot of times their parents actually will grab them and say, no, 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 don't go over there. And I guess it makes sense if you're in New York, because a lot of people are giving away things, but they ask for money after. So kids tend to be the most trusting, and I guess as adults we kind of lose that because we've been approached so many times and burned so many times by street vendors.
Have no friends, but what I saw.
I think it's beautiful. I think that's nice. I think it'll bring a lot of smiles to people's faces, make someone's day. I like it.
Now, no one's been really outwardly mean to me, although the first 2 days I was approaching people instead of not having the sign. And people would just ignore, it's New York, I mean, people would just ignore you or say no. Mostly they did it politely. I'm not trying to sell anything, I'm not trying to market anything. As long as they can realize that, then they seem to be okay with it. But a lot of people, I would say, depending on where I was, probably about 80% of people said no. Just based on the fact that they're being handed something, which happens at every corner in New York.
This is awesome. It's nice to meet you, Ted. And
yeah.
You said the 11th, East 9th, right?
On Saturday, yeah.
Saturday?
Saturday, 5:30.
Awesome. Cool. Thank you. This is awesome. Thank you so much. We appreciate it.
Gallery opened up about, we're coming up to our second year in business in October, and our gallery is used primarily to showcase the works of artists that do work on the streets, specifically New York, or artists that started doing their artwork in New York City, down in the East Village or on the Lower East Side. So essentially that's the mandate for the gallery, work with artists that are part of the historical components of the East Village. I had seen Ted's work at one point on the internet. There had been some email exchanges, and I liked what I saw, and then Ted came down here and introduced himself, and we had an opportunity to speak a little bit further and sort of work on a plan for doing a show. It took some massaging, and it took almost probably a year from the initial communications to what you see now here hanging in the gallery. The public art project that Ted did, you know, took a number of conversations and sort of tweakings, if you would, to get it to what eventually transpired over the last 10 days. You know, the initiative to bring art to the people and give it away is in direct contrast with what I do as a business owner. I mean, I would love to give art away and have a whole kumbaya experience for everybody, but, you know, it's a business. So a free art component was sort of flying in the face of the traditional format of commerce in the art world. What I liked about it is that Ted and we really discussed this through, because I wanted to make sure that it wasn't like an anti-art component or an anti-gallery component too, that in some way, it complemented. And I think really what came out of it is Ted has developed a style, if you would, a brand. And I don't mean that in a commercial way, but he's developed a signature style for himself. And by virtue of the fact that he went onto the streets of New York to literally push that and engage people in art, I think it's tremendous, because there's a lot of people that don't get, or intimidated by art, or don't get the accessibility that art has. and how easy it is to get. It doesn't have to be, you know, $1 million Sotheby's painting. You know, for $50 you can get something collectible, or less or more, you know, depending whatever your budget is. But you know, the ability to want to engage an artist is an important step, and people are intimidated by it. And I think by the fact that Ted was literally out there walking the streets with a mandate of giving out 100 pieces a day, with a total goal of giving over 1,000 works out over a 10-day period, I thought was super, super ambitious. And that was another thing that really sort of solidified what I wanted to see in this exhibition.
First of all, I thought that handing them out in New York would be really interesting, because I used to live in New York and I never ever took anything off the street, so I really wanted to see how people's interactions were with him in terms of handing them out. But again, I think that he did so many pieces, and that how much time he actually spent on each one showed through, and it's thousands of hours, so I think that was really remarkable.
Well, I think it's a great idea. I think that, you know, some art, to put a price on art is hard. Sometimes art is completely overvalued. Sometimes art is completely undervalued. I think free is a good start, because like that at least you can share what the artist really wanted to, you know, to give away, with money or without. So I think it's a great concept. I'm very happy that I stumbled upon this. Don't have it subserved, legend in the making. No, you concur, gotta write this damn now. What's next is a blur. If you don't agree, you don't gotta read a new chapter in my life with dreams made at the same. A shitty gallery, hard work equals a salary. Girls calling us up for people we are battered. Tell them that we out of reach, sick of pretending.